Looking to simplify the process of allocating values across accounts and dimension members in your planning tasks? In SAP Analytics Cloud, you can use the allocation steps in Data Actions to automate the process of distributing values from a source using a driver to calculate what proportion each target should receive. In this example, operating expenses have all been assigned to the unassigned or no value member of the product dimension. If you were to divide the expenses equally between the product categories, the youth product category would be responsible for a disproportionate amount of the total given its contribution to the bottom line. However, by taking advantage of allocation steps in SAP Analytics Cloud Data Actions, you can use an account such as net revenue as a driver to determine what portion of the expenses should be allocated to each product category. You can start by specifying a name and default model for the data action that will act as a container for the process. Next, you can add the allocation step. Keep in mind that you can perform multiple types of steps as part of a data action, where each step is executed in sequence when the data action is triggered. For more information, refer to the other videos on data actions on this channel. When configuring the allocation step, you first define the source context, which refers to the values that you want to allocate. By default, a parameter is included for the version. For this type of step, the version is the same for both source and target. You can add any other filters that might be applicable. Here, you can limit the source context to the operating expenses so that only those values will be redistributed. If you want, you can choose to keep the source value so that amounts are allocated to the target dimension members without being deducted from the source dimension member. You can also choose to add a reference dimension, which enables you to specify a different driver for each member of that dimension. By default, the planning date dimension is automatically assigned as a reference dimension. For the target context, you can specify a booking account to keep a record of your allocation results for auditing purposes. You can also choose whether you want to overwrite the target, which reduces the value of the target members to zero at the start of the step. The last step is to define one or more allocation rules to specify the source, driver, and target for the allocation process. In this example, the source is the unassigned or no value member of the product dimension. Next, you can choose the driver, which is the variable that determines how much value to allocate to each member of the target. Here, that's the net revenue account. Finally, you can set the target. For this example, you can select the other categories in the product dimension. Keep in mind that when you choose the same dimension as both source and target, you can specify the number of repetitions for the step. Repetition is useful in cases where the allocation must be run several times to assign all the desired values to the target. Depending on the complexity of your own planning scenarios, you can add more combinations of source members and target members, add more source or target dimensions, such as adding region as an additional source dimension so that you can create rules that allocate values to different products for different regions, or add other allocation steps for completely different combinations of source and target dimensions. Multiple data actions can also be combined using multi-actions. Once all the rules are defined, you can save the data action. Back in the story, you can now add a trigger for the data action containing your allocation rules. When you trigger the data action, you're prompted to choose the appropriate planning version. Once the data action is complete, all amounts have been allocated from the No Value column to the other members, with the proportion determined by the member's contribution to net revenue. Be aware that if you have previously created standalone allocation processes as part of your planning tasks in SAP Analytics Cloud, you can easily migrate these existing processes to data actions. For more information on using allocation processes in SAP Analytics Cloud, check out the help topic links in the description and try it for yourself today.